We use imaging to study kids' brain development, both in typically developing kids and kids with neurodevelopmental disorders. All this knowledge that we learn over the last few decades about human brain development, we don't really see the knowledge being used in clinical practice. So the grand challenge in my field is how can we best use this as a tool and incorporate that into the standard clinical practice so that we can better diagnose kids and identify those at risk for any kind of neurodevelopmental disorder, but also use it as a way to track disease progress, and also how can we use it to evaluate treatment as well as intervention and see if any of those are effective in making sure that the kids have the best outcome possible. So my research attempt to meet the challenge in the field by using very unique study design. In addition to including patients in our study, we also include their biological siblings and other family members to really understand the brain abnormalities that we see in the patient, whether some of them are influenced more by genetic risk or some are more influenced by the environmental factors. So the goal of my research is to identify potential markers that can differentiate clinical population from the typically developmental problems. So the impact of my research is that we help clinicians to better plan more personalized treatment to improve the outcomes of kids with neurodevelopmental disorders. And one of the populations that we have started to look at is the population of kids with concussion. We're able to catch them at a very acute stage and see all these brain changes associated immediately after the concussion and really target their treatment based on what we see in the brain scan. And we can prevent any potential development of psychosocial problems later on. So I see the future here at CHLA. We will be able to have this very collaborative environment where clinicians and researchers like me work together and apply the best state-of-the-art technical approach, including imaging, into their clinical practice to really use them for developing individualized treatment and intervention for our kids.